Another important thing which RERA has done is to curb the misrepresentation or the fraud being done by the developers or the builders in this particular sector. With respect to misrepresentation and fraud, a lot of times various advertisements, brochures were circulated in the market to the buyers that this project has been granted such approvals, it will be delivered in X amount of time, it will be of X quality, this will be the developer who is going to develop it, this is a consortium agreement. A lot of misrepresentations used to be done. They used to take names of various celebrities into launching a project and then delivering the project, and most of those promises were not adhered to. Another practice was they used to create a sample flat, and by making that sample flat to be an idle flat, they used to sell the rest of the flats. And now the project which used to come over, none of those sample or the existing flats used to be in consonance with the sample flat. Now, to curb such misrepresentation and fraud, RERA has brought in section 12 under the legislation, which says that any buyer who suffers because of any misrepresentation or any false statement in a brochure or in a prospectus or in an advertisement will be duly compensated by the promoter of a project. So any kind of false statement with respect to the price of the project, price of the flat, or the quality or specifications of a flat, or most of the times they were home buyer used to be assured that there will be a common area, there will be parks over there, this would be the open space, this would be a clubhouse, this would be X facilities would be available to him. If any of those facilities are not available, any advertisement was a false advertisement or a false assurance, they will be duly compensated under the act by the promoter, who is the real estate developer.